Now, the next topic that we have is the column alias. So what exactly is column alias? When we give a salary hike, for example, select last name comma salary, and again salary plus salary multiplied by 0.5. So we are trying to give a salary hike of 50%, right? From hr.employees. Now, if you run this kind of query, what happens is this column name, I mean, it does not look good because Oracle SQL will print the same name on the output screen. So let us look at this query and then we will talk about column aliasing. So where is the SQL developer? Yeah. So in column aliasing, what you can do is you can rename the output column names. Just to keep it very simple for you. So any column name that you have in the output, if you want to rename it, then you will use this column aliasing method or column alias. You can use a different name for the output column. I think one of the students, he or she was asking about this column alias. And the next topic, we also have table alias. You can even use a different name for your tables that are available in the query. Oh, perfect. This is our last time queries. Okay, great. So what I'll do is I'll connect to the cloud. Let me put up the password. I think we already have so many queries. So what I'll do is for column alias, I'll use any one of the queries from the existing worksheet. Okay, I think we can go with this one. This looks good. So I'm running this query and let us look at the output. Now this is what I was saying. So we gave a $100 hike to everyone, but the output column name shows salary plus 100, all right? So it does not look good in the output. Now if I run this query, for example, let us run this query. It says last name and then salary minus 500. It doesn't look good in the output, right? Let us run this query. Now in this query, we have last name, salary multiplied by 0.2 and salary plus salary multiplied by 0.2. Now this column name does not convey a perfect name in the output, right? And let's take you print this kind of data. It will confuse everyone. So it's always good to have correct column naming conventions. Or in case if you are performing any operation, it's good to have human understandable column names, right? Because see, these kind of column names do not convey a concrete value to the end users. So what Oracle SQL allows you to do is you can even rename the output column names. So how do we do it? So that's where we use column alias. Let us run this query first. Okay, let me run this query. Now in this case, we gave how much? A 50% hike to every employee, right? But this column name, it does not look good because it prints the same column name. So what you can do is, after the column name, you can give a space and under double quotes, you will have to use double quotes. And inside the double quotes, you can write whatever the column name you want to give. So for example, in our case, we want to say 50% hike. And then let's run this one. Now, can you see? It says last name, salary, and then 50% hike. Perfect. So this way, let's take you want to give, rather than last name, you just want to print name. So what you can do, give a space after the column name. And inside the double quotes, you can specify name, right? And then run this query. Now you see name, salary, and 50% hike. So this way you have more control on changing the column names in the output result. So how do you do it? After the column name, give a space, then under the double quotes, you can write whatever the column name you want to give, right? So over here, let's take, rather than salary, I want to write original salary and then run this one. So now our output result says it's name, original salary and 50% hike. All right, so that's column aliasing. It's easy to rename your columns in the output results.